Hello, Luke. It's been a bumpy ride till now, but what a gift you are. You've turned our worlds upside down and anchored your existence into every fiber of our beings. You and Aiden kickstarted a cascade of life-changing moments that transformed the lives of society. On Sunday morning, 5 August 2012, when Mommy was only 17 weeks pregnant, an unexpected turn of events led to complications with your brother Aiden's development as a result of a small rupture in his amniotic sac. With no water and limited moving space, we were advised that Aiden would soon pass away and inevitably lead to the loss of both you and your brother. Our hearts were shattered. We had to face a tough decision: operate and terminate the pregnancy, or try and make it until Mommy is 25 weeks pregnant. We decided to press on, surrounding ourselves with faith and hope, and spread the news to friends and family. A movement of prayers and dreams followed soon after, wherein people, some we know, others we've never heard of, stood together in unity, one-minded about life, focused on trusting to get you two as far as possible. We knew that for us to get you guys to 25 weeks, Aiden would have to keep on fighting for his life for 8 weeks. It seemed like an impossible task. We took small steps, day by day, sonar to sonar, each time amazed that your hearts are still beating strong. Then, on 26 September 2012, early in the morning, at 25 weeks, Aiden said, "This is it. I'm tired. I've come this far, and now it's time for you, Luke, to carry on. You have a fighting chance now. Go, Luke. Your story is beginning, and I will gladly be a part of your story." There you were, a tiny little boy with a big heart and a little fire that your brother passed to you. You amazed us every day, fighting death and clinging on to life. Today you're 5 days old, and this milestone brings a very special gift. Today will be the first day that Daddy is allowed to kangaroo. Your heart has been beating together with Mommy's heart till now, but today, Daddy has a chance to feel your wildly beating heart. And what a heart you have. God will intercede.
Come on back. Dear Luke, it's been a year since your birth and the first time I held your tiny 690-gram body. This has been the best year of our lives. All of a sudden, the 8 weeks of uncertainty, pain and tears seem like seconds. The 108 days in hospital are broken up into the first time you opened your eyes, your first bath, first smile, and first outfit. It seems that the heart-shattering sadness of loving and losing your brother has more purpose now than ever before. He fought for you and he fought to meet us, and those 14 hours he breathed with us still amazes me today. You have the same fighting spirit, battling viruses, 2 infections, at the same time, numerous blood transfusions and a few scary procedures. You made it look so easy when I knew your tiny body shouldn't have to go through this.
Aiden, our little fire. For 52 days, you fought a good fight. Every second you fought was for your brother Luke. Your fight gave him a fighting chance. Every second you lived is accounted exponentially to the life of Luke, which he lives to full every day. We didn't expect anything from you, and yet you gave us everything. I wanted the world to see how freely you moved the moment you came into the world, reminding us that although you had no space in the womb, you still fought. I saw you, I saw your spirit. I felt you, and I still feel your spirit. We acknowledge your existence. Your little fire is the light and life that is you. I don't want to think that all of this was a mistake or that it shouldn't have happened. The more I think about it, the more I realize that you two boys started an adventure. You took a risk and through that gave us something that we didn't realize before. That life is worth living at any given moment, no matter what the circumstances or the consequences of choices made. Aiden, you started your little fire which gave the light that is Luke. You boys will never cease to exist, albeit momentarily in different forms, but always the same in our hearts. We love you. Our lives will never ever be the same. The revelation of brotherly love has given us life. Here we are now, 108 days later in NICU, and you have fought your way out of hospital and into our new car bought specially for you. You fit perfectly. You are going home.
You are pure joy. There's no other way to describe the feeling I get when I hear you laugh, when I see the excitement on your face every morning as you realize that this is a new day, when I watch you sleep and still can't believe you are ours, and of course, when you so adamantly need us to know just how unhappy you are with the pumpkin we are giving you or the grown-up conversation we are excluding you from. You are perfect, lacking nothing, showing us just how beautiful life is and reminding us to make seconds count. You are here because of friends we know and friends we made in the process. You are here because you have amazing grandparents and aunts and uncles who love you like you are their own. You are here because of a doctor who believes in God and life. You are here because of nurses working through the night, putting lines into your tiny veins and feeding you drops of milk through tubes. You are here because your dad kept me sane when I really couldn't go any longer. You are here because you wanted to be. You are here because love always wins. The same that is God.